call Odera, the coach of Chipu and Kenya under 20. Can you tell us where your steps are in preparation for May and also you guys qualifying for the next level?
Well, currently the preparations in terms of conditioning much better than they were last year.
Yeah.
In terms of their strength,
yes,
and power,
yes,
and also their speed. Where the preparations are not where we want to be are their endurance.
Yeah.
In terms of being able to repeatedly work hard during the game.
Yeah.
So that is a challenge for us to try and get them up to the required standard.
Yeah.
By end of March when we are going to play in the tournament. So that's conditioning wise. Skills wise, there is a bit of concern with the back line. I think it's not just a problem with the under 20, but a problem within Kenya Rugby.
Yes.
That we are not producing very skillful centers and wingers.
Yeah.
So we have big strong players, but they are not able to tactically read the game well. But the good thing about these young boys is they are very willing to learn. So with every session, they are getting better.
Okay.
And I think looking at how much progress they've made in this short time, if they continue with this trajectory, then they should be ready for the tournament at the end of March.
Okay.
Yes.
You've spoken about tactics and where Kenya is in terms of players playing tactically.
Mm-hmm.
So for you, what do you think needs to be done more in the game? Because you're handling a facet of the sport where you're bringing in players to a larger pool of where elite players will be after a certain period.
Yes.
Yeah, what do you think that we need to do so that Kenya Rugby in future plays according to tactically and just matches other teams on and off the pitch?
That's a very good question.
Yes.
I think number one,
yes,
we need to spread this game much further,
yes,
than the urban centers.
Yes.
So majority of the strong clubs are in Nairobi,
okay,
and then some in Nakuru, and then Kisumu surprisingly is not producing a good club. So first we must spread the game,
yes,
further out. Number two, we've got to go to the grassroots.
Yes.
9, 8 year olds, 10, 11 year olds,
yes,
that's where the game is.
Yes.
So if we spread the game and then take it to younger players, then now we are talking. Because if you look at some of our players, yeah, they start playing maybe in Form 2, Form 3, some of them. And we don't have very many good coaches across the country. So what happens is I'm getting these players, they are strong, they are quick, but they're not able to appreciate some of the tactics of the game. So if we want to compete at the highest level, at the elite level, we've got to spread the game to rural areas as far as possible. And then take the game to the younger children. We do that, and I think we'll be in with a good opportunity to compete. And we can only do that by getting good coaches, many good coaches across the country at lower levels. Then we'll be able to see a difference.
Okay.
Yes.
And you're now potentially handling a team that not just for this competition, just qualifying for the Junior World Cup Trophy. You have a team that can basically in future make Kenya's name proud in terms of just the next World Cup in 2023.
Yes.
And also the next, let's say, if players just progress into sevens or just the national game. What do you think you as a coach, we are bringing to the game, what needs to be done for them in the future so that when the next World Cup cycle reaches, we are sure we can guarantee our players can be up there?
Okay, well, those are two questions. On the first one, what am I bringing to the game? Well, I played for this team myself. I played for the Kenya schools and played for Kenya under 19 side in 1984 and 1986. So with it, I'm bringing a lot of experience being in this national setup, and of course the pride that goes with the shirt. Now, for us to compete at the next World Cup in 15 aside, the key people are actually the clubs.
Yes.
Because the clubs are the ones who spend the most time with the players. I only see these players once a week for when there is an assignment specifically. But the people they're with week in, week out, off season and pre-season are their club coaches and their clubs. So we must bring in the clubs very close to the national team setup, how we are running coaching sessions, some of the skills we are looking for. And if the coaches can take up some of that, or if the clubs can take up some of the responsibility, then we'll be able to improve the players much quicker. So in 2023, when we want to compete, if the clubs can be able to do their bit in developing the players, then we as the national team also do our part. You see, then we'll get the players improving a lot more. But without the clubs, without parents, and without the schools, right, it's going to be a big challenge for us to be competitive in 2023.
Yeah. So the key is clubs and schools.
Clubs and schools are the key. Okay. Those are the key stakeholders at the moment, because they spend the most time with these players.
Okay.
So if we can get the people who spend the most time with the players to be able to improve them, then we can be able to compete.
Okay.
Yeah.
And people out there, and they might not know you, or they know you, but they just want to know who Paul Odera is. Maybe you can just give us a brief history about you, your journey in the sport, to where you are right now as the head coach of the junior Kenya team.
I started playing rugby when I was 9, here at RFEA.
Yes.
That was when the rugby patrons launched the first ever mini rugby program. I played on to St. Mary's. I used to play at Consolata Primary School, then on to St. Mary's. I captained St. Mary's for 3 years, then captained the Kenya schools. Then came to Kenya Harlequins here, played for Queens, captained Queens. I captained the Kenya Sevens in 2001. Won the Safari Sevens here in 2004, I think. Then did my coaching certifications. In 2000, I did my level 2. In 2011, 2010, I qualified as a level 3 coach. And that's the highest coaching qualification in the world. And I've been at that level since 2010. And then I coached this team in 2005 and 2006. And I left and then came back to coach them again in 2015. So that's been my journey pretty much around rugby. Yes.
And your journey, which has been your key moment or your key highlight for you in the sport, that that you felt that this is what I've been striving to do and I've achieved?
Being captain in the Kenya Sevens team,
yes,
was a big highlight for me,
yes,
to Dubai,
yes,
and Durban.
Yes.
And a key highlight as well was that we were the first ones to start winning.
Yes.
We won the shield,
yes,
in both Dubai and Durban. So for me, that was a big pinnacle of my career. I'd always dreamt of captaining Kenya. Although my first tournament as well for Kenya in Sevens, and also my first match for the Kenya 15s team. Those are days, you know, you don't forget. And I think those were highlights and pivotal moments for me. Around coaching, I think getting my level 3 certificate, particularly what was a highlight for me is that the grade I scored was probably one of the highest of compared to other coaches around the world. So that for me was a great moment of pride for that. So I think for me those are pivotal moments. Yeah.
Thank you.